plant and animal tissues. Parenchyma tissue. Materials required: prepared slide of parenchyma tissue and a compound microscope. Procedure: place the prepared slide of parenchyma tissue on the stage of the compound microscope. Observe the features of the parenchyma tissue through the lens of the compound microscope. Observations: all cells are isodiametric in shape, which means the cells have the same length and width. The cells in the tissue are loosely packed with large intercellular spaces between each cell. The cells contain cytoplasm and a nucleus and are surrounded by a cell wall. Each cell has a vacuole in the center. Inference: as the cells have a thin cell wall, are isodiametric in shape and have a large vacuole that is present in the cytoplasm, we can confirm that the tissue seen on the slide is a parenchyma tissue. Sclerenchyma. Materials required: prepared slide of sclerenchyma tissue and a compound microscope. Procedure: place the prepared slide of the sclerenchyma tissue on the stage of the compound microscope. Observe the features of the sclerenchyma tissue through the lens of the compound microscope. Observations: sclerenchyma tissue consists of thick-walled dead cells. These cells are long, narrow, and have hard and extremely thick secondary walls due to uniform distribution of lignin. There are no intercellular spaces between the cells in the sclerenchyma tissue. The cell contains little or no protoplasm. Nucleus is absent in the cell. The cell contains empty vacuoles that are called lumen. Inference: as the cells have thickened cell walls and little protoplasm, we can confirm that the tissue seen on the slide is a sclerenchyma tissue. Striated muscle. Materials required: prepared slide of striated muscle tissue and a compound microscope. Procedure: place the prepared slide of striated muscle tissue on the stage of the compound microscope. Observe the features of the striated muscle tissues through the lens of the compound microscope. Observations: the striated muscle cells are very long and have cylindrical fibers. The fibers are enclosed within a membrane called sarcolemma. These fibers are nucleated, which means they have many nuclei. Each cell cytoplasm consists of many myofibrils. Each myofibril contains alternate light and dark bands, giving a striated appearance to the fibers. Inference: the presence of long cylindrical fibers that are multinucleated and the presence of many myofibrils confirms that the cells seen on the slide are striated muscle cells. Nervous tissues. Materials required: prepared slide of nerve tissue and a compound microscope. Procedure: place the prepared slide of the nerve tissue on the stage of the compound microscope. Observe the features of the nerve tissues through the lens of the compound microscope. Observations: the large body of the neuron is called the soma, which contains the cell's nucleus. The cell body branches out to form the dendrites. These dendrites further branch out to form fibers of different lines called dendrites. There is also a single long fiber projecting from the cell body called the axon. The axon is covered by the myelin sheath. Inference: the presence of cells with a large cell body, one prominent nucleus, dendrites and a large axon confirms that tissue seen on the slide is nerve tissue.